programs that run in the console don't have to look drab. They can be as colorful and have presentation as dynamic as a full-blown graphic or web interface, as long as you have the right libraries. In Python, there's a few libraries to create striking text mode presentations. One of the most popular is Rich, as in rich text. And in this video, we're going to take a quick tour of what kinds of fancy text features Rich can give you. Let's begin with a few basic examples of how to format text with Rich. The most basic thing you can do is add colors and formatting to console text. What's more, you have a few different ways you can accomplish this. Generally, when you use Rich, the first thing to import is Rich's custom override for the print function. This way, all the prints in your program get routed through Rich if you just want to make it easy. You can also import Rich's print under a different name and use that if you'd rather preserve the original print when you need it. To add colors or styling, you use HTML-like markup enclosed in square brackets. For instance, to make text red, you use red, and you here will add underlining. If you want to print something that's already in brackets, you just use a backslash to escape the brackets, like this. You can also construct stylized text programmatically in a couple of different ways. You can create a text object and append to it different bits of text with style descriptors. This here gives us a hello in its base text color, and world in green italicized text. Another method we can use is assemble, which lets you supply texts alone or texts paired with style descriptors. Between these methods, and there are others too, you can generate stylized text in a quick and dirty way, or in a more sophisticated and controlled way. Rich gives you many elaborate tools for formatting. The panel construct, for instance, lets you take text objects and render them in a box with a title, a style border, and other customizable formatting. You can also display text in grids, or, my favorite because it's so hard to do otherwise, a tree view. Tree views for text have to be created programmatically, and the order in which the leaves on the tree is added is important. Rich also gives us tools for live updates to content. One common example of this is a progress bar. You can use a simple for in statement with Rich's track function to create a progress bar and update it periodically. The time left is computed automatically, and you can also set the percentages and other values as needed, or you can have the progress bar be indeterminate. It can just have activity to show you that updates are going on, for instance. Another useful function is live updates to an object. The live object lets us take something, like this tree, and allow changes to it to be rendered progressively. I've added sleep statements to this to show off the effect a little bit more explicitly, but you can see how this would allow the tree to be edited and updated in real time. Rich also gives you control over layouts of objects across the screen using an abstraction called a layout. In this example, I create a screen layout and then split it into two sections, one for movies and one for actors. I can then update each of those layouts independently of each other. I can add or change text or formatting freely. Now, these demonstrations should give you a basic idea of what's possible with Rich. However, one thing Rich doesn't address is full interactivity, like taking user input in any form other than an input line on the console. There are other libraries that make the console into something much more like a full-blown graphical interface with freeform input handling and many other things, but we'll explore those in other videos. So that's it for this episode. If you liked it, leave a comment below, and don't forget to follow Dev the Serdar and InfoWorld on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.